Hi everyone. Today I want to share a case study of a pen company called Parker. And they had this product called the Parker 5th, which is a very interesting pen that they created. There was nothing like it before. However, the pen is already discontinued due to some possibly design problems, which is what I'm going to talk about today, especially on the customer insights part. And before I go further, you can find me on LinkedIn. My name is Joseph Lee. And this video is not really made to bash the company Parker. I'm actually a fan and I do own several Parker pens and I enjoy them. So what is the Parker 5th? The Parker 5th, it's something that looks like a fountain pen. In fact, it is not. You can see from a real fountain pen, the nib is very different. And this is the backside of the nib. You see something that is sticking out on the tip right here for writing. And what it is actually nothing more than a felt tip pen or fine liner. The nib part over here, it's basically just a cover. You see, this is just like a hood. It does nothing. And it is more like a pen within a pen kind of design. You can see the fine liner is just pen that sits inside this barrel right here. They sell it as refills, which costs $8 to $10 each. And the pen itself is about $180. The price of the pen is not outrageous, so to speak, compared to their other products. However, the refill are very overpriced. Tying this to design thinking, we usually see this Venn diagram of three important elements: the user, business, and technology. When they come together, we see innovation in the middle. If you need to draw another fourth element, it would be sustainability. What we usually see is these three elements are presented in the same size. They're drawn in the same size. It's kind of like they are equally important for the company and they are paying the same amount of attention to each element. Well, is this the case for Parker? We can find out. They seem to put more attention on the business side in this case. It has to make business sense to a company, right? So after all, as a company, we are making products and services that is true to our core value and also true to our core business. At the end, we still have to make it a financially sound project. So imagine what the pitch meeting of the Parker 5th was like. They are making a brand new and exciting pen, which is true. There's nothing like it. The pen that looks like a fountain pen without all the fuss. I think this may be one of the key deciding factor on designing this pen. The fountain pen needs to be refilled. It's either from a bottle or using some ink cartridge. It's not as fuss-free as just putting on a refill and throw away the old one. So in that case, they probably have to make a new refill for this pen. The pen certainly would have the Parker luxury feel and touch to it, which is also true at the end. We can deduce to the motivation for Parker is they wanted to create a new product for non-fountain pen users, which is like a pen that looks like a fountain pen, but without all the inconvenience. And it's definitely needs to be different from a rollerball or gel pen. It's very easy to forget about the key customer insights, and you will still have a checklist of all the things that checks out, such as making a quality product, it's trendy, it's stylish, it's reliable, and it's a true Parker pen. Based on the price, the profitability is also making sense. It's reasonable, and they do have enough marketing on it as well. So everything kind of checks out, right? If they go ahead with this, this is what it actually looks like. It's heavily based on business decisions. There are some technologies to help them to make this pen happen, but very little focus on the users. I would say they still have some users' insights because they want to make a pen that is convenient enough for non-fountain pen users to pick up. But this is a very small portion of the decision, you can see. To give you a summary, the Parker 5th is supposed to be a pen for non-fountain pen users. They are actually a fine liner pen, just fit inside a fancier outer body. The problem is the fifth is universally panned by the fountain pen community. Anybody that reviewed this pen, they did not like it. The non-fountain pen users, they are not completely satisfied with the look of the fake nib because it does look very fake. And the review is way overpriced. The pen is now discontinued, and the questions that we have is, why did they make such a decision on making an unusual pen like this? And are there anything missing in the design process, such as key customer insights? And our answer to that is, they definitely missed the opportunity to get the insights from the super users of fountain pens, basically the fans. And from their perspective, they kind of understand that why people don't use fountain pens, and we can kind of look at them. First is the fountain pen is all about the user experience. There's nothing quite like it. People don't use it because they never get to try it. It's the lack of experience. If they try it, they probably would like it. And of course, there are also some concepts or misconceptions about fountain pens are kind of troublesome. You have to refill the ink and you have to write with a certain light pressure. And the paper choice is also very important. Even flying with a fountain pen, if you're not careful, it may cause some accidents on spilling inks. You must learn how to write properly with a fountain pen. And of course, there are some maintenance involved, such as cleaning. However, there are still a lot of people want a fine writing instrument as a luxury item. And nothing really gives you that feeling from something other than a fountain pen. Somehow the rollerballs and ballpoint pens, they don't look classy enough. And it's not like Parker never tried. They even make a whole line of pens that they offer choices on rollerball and fountain pens. And you can see if you cap the pen, you cannot even tell which is which. And it's only by the time when you take out the pen and start writing with it in maybe in front of people, they can see they are writing with something that looks like a ballpoint pen, which is not considered very classic. There's something about writing with a nib that looks like this. And of course, the writing experience from the fountain pen is also very different. We know that the look of the nib is important, and also the writing experience is important. For writing experience, I don't think the fineliner pen provides the best experience. And the look of the nib definitely doesn't quite cut it. It may look like a fountain pen from a distance, but if you kind of pay attention, you will know right away it's not a real pen. It's, a real fountain pen. It's a fake. So to me, it's really kind of like something like this, right? If you wear a t-shirt and you pretend you're wearing a tie and shirt, it just doesn't work. And on their marketing end, they do design a lot of different variations. And for this pen, they look kind of nice. To be honest, just the nib part is weird. And they kind of know it already. They only talk about style, and they talk about easy writing experience, but they don't say compare to what. They dare not mention fountain pen in their materials. A fineliner pen is actually also made for drawing more than writing. And the biggest problem is they are not expensive. You can buy a very nice fineliner pen in the market for a fraction of the price than the review. And they basically offer the exact same, if not better, writing experience. Since they're made for drawing, they come with a lot of different kinds of width, which Parker doesn't offer, and also tons of colors. And they are really not expensive. I found this set, which is 120 pens with different colors, and the price is only like $44. So we can see from the user's point of view, the look of the fake nib is a problem. The pricing, especially the review, is a problem. And the perceived value is also a problem. It's nothing more than a dress-up fineliner pen, and it's quite expensive if you look at the overall value that they offer. I even interview a couple shops that sells pens, and they don't like it. The people in the shop, they actually don't like it themselves, and they got feedback from the customers early on. They were all very negative. So basically, they were saying these pens are hated by all the fans, and they stopped carrying it after a short while. So even the people who are selling these pens, they don't want to sell it. They don't want to have anything to do with it. Quick recap. The fineliner pens are mainly made for drawing. There are a lot of choices in the market that Parker does not offer. And the proprietary review is basically the nail on the coffin. I think they make this to be too specialized. It doesn't have a lot of value added to it, but it's very expensive to make and very hard to find by the consumers because it's only offered by Parker. And the price is also very high. And the writing experience of these fineliner pens are still inferior to the fountain pen. So had they talked to the early adopters or innovators, there are other names for them, such as like enthusiasts, super users, super fans, the influencers. If they spend more time talk to these people, I'm sure within hours, they would find out that Parker 5th is not a great solution, because all the people who actually enjoy their brand, Parker the brand, and enjoy the pens, they all hate this. They would not buy it, and they would not recommend people to buy it. And new users, if they start using the pen, I think soon enough, they will find out this is not exactly what they want. So what do they want? In general, the fountain pen users, they're looking for, as I mentioned before, the ultimate user experience, the touch and feel, the precision, the consistency, the diversity of fountain pens, all kinds of nibs and barrels you can choose from, and the amount of choices, especially on ink. There are literally more than 1,000 kinds of ink you can find in the market. And the aesthetics and the build quality of the pens are also different price points. They offer different quality and choices for customers. They are very environmental friendly. And last but not least, the nostalgia and prestige of using a real fountain pen, especially on the high-end market. Are there any alternatives? Here are some ideas I want to present to you guys. The pen inside a pen concept, it's not exactly brand new, and there are other companies that are doing the same thing. The difference is such as this. They offer a low-price solution. The pens that fit into this case is actually something you can pick up from a stationery store for a really low price, and they are very popular, such as like this Pentel sign pen. The case itself is about 5,000 yen, which is not a lot, and they do offer different kinds of shape and colors for people to choose from. What about the writing experience? To me, the fineliner is not the better solution. I find this needle tip gel pen writes not exactly same as a fountain pen, but it's pretty close. Probably the closest thing to writing with the fountain pen. And the good thing is they offer refills at very low price. And if somehow Parker can OEM this kind of refill to fit their pens, it may be a solution. Of course, if they want to redesign another Parker with the same design philosophy, I would make the nib to look like a real fountain pen nib and put the refill underneath it. But of course, if you do this, it won't be cheap. And also, at the end of the day, it's still making a fake fountain pen, and I'm not sure if the fans like it at all. So what about other solutions? In my opinion, I kind of lean towards reframing and reintroducing the concept of using a real fountain pen rather than just jumping in and making a new product for people who haven't really tried fountain pens or used one. The beauty of it is the fountain pen is really a lifetime product. And if you take care of them, they last for a long time. And luckily, for users who start using fountain pens, they seem to be enjoying so much, they would start collecting them. the market is actually booming for the last decade. If that is the case, it would be the manufacturer's job to figure out what do they want to buy next. And the fountain pen is no longer having the image of something that is used only by old men. The new buyers, they include many younger people, both male and female, and they do buy anything from low end to high end. And Parker, as a company with such a long history, they actually already have a lot of solutions addressing to the users' pain points and non-users' desire. They have something like ink that dries fast, so they don't smear that much, and they have ink that doesn't bleed through or feather on even cheaper papers like office copier paper. The users, if they prefer not to get their fingers dirty by refilling from a bottle, there's always the option to try refilling with the ink cartridge. This is really like people who likes to make their own cup of cappuccino at home or listening to vinyl records. Inconvenience is not on the top of their priority list, but the user experience is. And if you ask these people, are they willing to spend a little bit more money to be able to enjoy the superior user experience? I bet they would say yes. And if I were Parker, I would definitely spend a lot more resources on connecting with these super users and talk to them and find out what would excite them. What do they like to buy next? And if they want to make another fine liner pen or needle tip pen, nobody is stopping Parker. I just want to say, whatever you do, don't make it another fake fountain pen. And definitely think about the cost of the refill. Never make another overpriced refill for those pens, because nobody wants them. So this is the final recap. Parker was kind of reinventing the wheel for no reason at all. They do it just because. And the need of the new product is mostly driven by marketing and sales decisions. There is little or no evidence of any input from the super users or influencers. And the solution doesn't really fit well into the core product line of Parker, which I think is their fountain pens. And the proprietary review of the product offer unknown demand is making it very expensive to make, both expensive and difficult to find for the customers. So the lessons that I learned from this case study is remember to design with the customer insights. So that's all I want to share today. Thank you so much for watching this video and staying with me until the very end. I'll see you next time. Thank you. Bye.